for the participants to take note some of the leading cases of which she has been part of. Recently, Anuja had filed an PIL, that is a public interest litigation, in Supreme Court, seeking a direction to the central government to ensure that there should be clear guidelines for registration of cases relating to marital rape and frame the guidelines and laws for it. She has also filed a PIL basically seeking directions to this from the centers to implement the clear guidelines and issue instruction to flying squad, invigilators, supervisors during the exams. She has also filed a petition on the subject matter of fake news before the Supreme Court. More importantly, she, as in my beginning in the introduction, I mentioned that she is not only a lawyer and a criminal psychologist per se, but she contributes a lot to the society as well. One of the biggest example can be the PIL what she filed in the Kathua rape and murder case, where she demanded the CBI probe into the matter, into the Court of Chief Justice of India at that point of time, Lordship Deepak Mishra. Many media houses had published the viewpoint of Advocate Anuja on the issue. There are lots of other matters where she has appeared. One of them would be very worthwhile to mention was she filed a criminal writ petition in the Mumbai High Court as a petitioner, that is advocate in person, in the most brutal case of model and minor cigarette burn case where the high police officials and influential political persons were involved in the case. Honorable Justice Ranjit More took a cognizance in the case and directed Anuja and also congratulated her for assisting the case without any personal benefits and bringing it to the notice of the court. Now, I'll also like to inform that Anuja is also founder of an NGO named Nirbhaya Ek Shakti. Recently, Anuja was also launched by Zee Media Group in a crime series named as Sheena Investigate, where she plays procrastinatist and tries to transform the minds of the people to help recognize any wrong deeds happening around us. It will be worthwhile to mention that almost all leading news channels on other media houses, including CNN, Lok Sabha TV, Republic TV, India Today, Aaj Tak, Zee News, and etc. Apart from that, the leading news papers like Hindustan Times, the Deccan Chronicle, Jan Shakti, Pioneer, Punjab Kesari, etc., the magazines like The Week, etc., also covers her. Anuja, I think I have run out of steam introducing her because it can be a marathon. Introducing you is not what to say. It's something like a 2020, but it can be a very challenging thing for any host. So I'll beg pardon from you instead of introducing you furthermore because we are already late today. Already your profile has been shared with all our esteemed participants. Now the floor is all yours. We will request you to share your inspirational, motivational story of your life. Also, you are a very motivational speaker, which I am very sure today participants would be encountering that and taking some good, the benefit out of your wisdom. The floor is all yours.
So thank you so much. I'm so humbled to hosted by you, Rishikesh. And an extended thanks and my gratitude to Udaan Solitaires and team and to all the audience whose love towards me is always overwhelming. And I have found myself loved and supported by all of you every time when I have required that support in my life. When people say that you need women empowerment, I see that it is the true thing. Because here, when we talk about women empowerment, I'm already empowered. But apart from that, when I see you all supporting me for such a beautiful cause, I am always, always there with you all. I hope I am I'm able to. You're all are listening to me, Rishikesh?
Yes. We are listening to you.
Yeah. So because your video is off, so I thought I was not able to.
Yes.
Yes. As Rishikesh has been pointing about my credentials in life, I would just say that these credentials in life I was not born with. And it came up to me with a lot of hard work. And my path, my journey, whenever someone sees me here, when he was talking, when he was introducing me, and every time when I listen to my profile, you know what, I stand up to that profile once again every time I listen to it. Every time I have to become Anuja Kapoor. Every time I have to do that justice to my profile. And this journey with which I have become with what I am, and I'm still on that learning path, and I'm reaching to the goal of mine, which keeps changing, because you keep accomplishing and then you keep changing your goals. This is what you should be doing in your life, and this is what I have been doing. So when he was talking about, I was remembering my journey of these credentials when I was attaining them, when I was being a part of it. And when I look around on the awards which I have, you know, which so lovingly has been presented to me and been given to me, I'm always been humbled, because you know, you stand where you are today is all because love and support of each one of you. When there is a talk about a woman empowerment, this is what I was saying. Woman empowerment in India is a very difficult task, because a lot of people don't understand what's happening around when they want to understand what woman empowerment is. They feel that woman empowerment is just as you stand with her and you just tell her and just tell her that I'm there with you, and you just fund her. Woman empowerment is beyond this. Woman empowerment is to understand a woman first, to understand what she wants. And then over that period of journey, she will cry many times. She will have lot many of the problems. There will be time when she will share her sexual harassment experiences with you all. And that is the time when you will ask her to leave the job. That is where she finds it's very difficult. That when she comes back home and she tells to her partner or to her family that she's tired, and that is the time we are talking about woman empowerment, when her man stands up and say that, I am a part of you and I stand with you in the equal course. And if you are tired, I am also going to be a part of it. We will help the things around. This is woman empowerment. Woman empowerment is bringing woman on the forefront where she has been doing an excellent job as a homemaker at home. But because of an identity crisis, she has to take this forefront of earning a livelihood or making her mark. Why? Because people do not realize her being as a homemaker at home. They say that her job as a homemaker is like any other job, where she would be, you know, she's just a part of it. And but she's not been accomplished in that. And when she is looking and trying to make her mark as a homemaker, she's not able to do that, because it looks like a 24 hours job where she's not being paid. She struggles with her emotions, with her physical needs, with her mental needs, and with her psychological needs. Being empowered is very important when a man is being empowered. We want to bring an empowerment in women. Please, let's do it through man. I'm not saying that man is not empowered. I'm talking about where a man needs a woman to do her course when he can do by himself. So because the parents at our home is also not trying to do that, they're not empowering a man, because they're keeping everything and telling a woman to do it. And where a woman is able to handle both her job and her home, her kids, and when she comes back, she has everything. Why does she needs a man in her life is only maybe because of she wants to reproduce a baby, or maybe if there is some financial problem. But if she starts earning and there is an adoption, do you think she needs a man? No. So what is required is she needs a partner. You can become a husband, but you will not be able to become a partner of that woman. What you require is becoming a partner. So this is what where everybody has to understand that when you're giving birth to your children, don't differentiate between a boy and a girl. When the child is growing up, don't differentiate again with the course, with putting clothes on that body and when the child is in the infant stage and by telling that he's a boy or he's a or she's a girl. Because nothing is something which defines both of them. They both are into that same phase of life where they can be a part of each other's life. It is on the onus is on the parents, on the mother. So what is important is that mother needs to be empowered at that time when she's carrying the child. Do not force a mother to give birth to a boy, because it is never her who gives birth to a boy. It is in the hands of a man or in the chromosomes. But we forget and we keep telling a woman to give birth to a boy. This is something which is really looked upon. And if she delivers a girl, again, she's been typecast. So what is important is that even a man cannot pick up a chromosome, a Y chromosome, and put and attach with an X chromosome and can give a boy to anybody. It is not possible. So what we need to do is changing a mindset is, first of all, welcome a woman. If you are talking to me today, it's because my mother did not kill me in the womb, because she loved me throughout. Why? Because every friend of mine loves me. My children believe in me. My husband believes in me. So, and this is why today I'm standing and sitting in front of you, that there goes a woman who has taken up a lot of this journey of pain and struggle, because outside her home, she wants another home, which she will not find. Because outside she is being, there is a sexual harassment which is there. And there are this, because my area is a man world area, because criminology, psychology, victimology, already special police officer to Northwest District. I'm a SPO of my Thana, which is a model town Thana. I have an NGO, and all about is as an advocate, a woman, a mother, a wife, a daughter, and a friend. And now when we talk about as a role model, it is a very big, you know, it's on your shoulder, the power, the responsibility is on your shoulder. So when a lot of power comes to you, a lot of responsibility comes to you. For me, this journey of mine was not the way you see me today. I was just an another town girl, or you know, just another girl next to your door, next to your home. And I got married at the age of 20. I'm a Punjabi girl, and I have three sisters. We are three sisters. I'm the eldest, and my parents are very, very strict parents, because they were the parents of three girls, and there was no brother, and so three girls, and we have to be very careful. And this was our always a motto, that always remain in your mind that you belong to a family where your sisters are also going to get married. So never do anything, Anuja, where your sisters can not get married or bring a bad name to our family. So this onus was a very big onus on me. So that is why when I was in college, or my schooling was from, I did my schooling from two schools. So I had been schooling from Rosewood. Studied till ninth class out there, and because it has not had 11th and 12th, so I was just there till ninth, and then from there only I shifted to Queen Mary School, and then that was a girls' school. So from co-ed school I changed to a girls' school. So I able to understand the scenario of a co-ed school, how the boy and a girl, they talk to each other. What is the kind of an environment is out there? And when I changed my school from co-ed to a girls' convent school, there again I saw the other kind. There's a different kind of an atmosphere out there. How a girl talks to a girl, what kind of a mythology they talk about, the ideology they have, and how the teachers they talk. So there's a different mindset in co-ed schools and in girls' school. And then I finished from there. 93, I passed out. I went to Mata Sundari College. That is again in South, it's Delhi University and South University here in Delhi. And from there, I finished with my psychology. I was a science student and I wanted to do, actually, I wanted to become a doctor. So I gave this exams and I also gave an exam in Army. And I got selected somehow, but my parents didn't wanted me to go there. So they didn't want me to leave, and they didn't want me to go to the army school and army medical college. And so then I was not being able to get into this doctorate thing because I always had a thing of helping people around. I was always a very compassionate person, and I always belonged to this category of being there for everyone. And I'm a great, I actually think a lot and I'm a deep thinker. And every time I would ask a question, yes, no, why it's happening, why it's not happening. So during my early stage, also many times my parents, they have told me that I was a very enthusiastic child and I always used to ask a lot of questions to a lot many people. And if I do not understand, I will ask questions in my classroom. And in parent-teacher meeting, my teacher would always say that she's a very, very inquisitive child. She always asks a lot of questions, but sometimes answers we don't know. And there are times also because I used to read a lot of Daniel Steele, and they were, during when I was like growing up, so a lot of books related to this. There were some TV serials which used. That was also there, and I used to keep looking into those, and I always used to imagine me being a younger detective. And so there were some people who used to work at our place. I always used to look into their bags and being very, and how do they go, what do they do in the kitchen, and what are they doing. So always I always had this got like towel kind of a thing, and I used to make it like a gun, and I used to stand behind the walls and just used to come like this. And I think it was always in me that I always wanted to become a detective kind of a person, and a doctor also. So that is why I have multifaceted. And I also, a lot of victimology white concerned me, because I think I also used to see whenever I used to see someone who was a victim, and I was used to feel very bad. I used to feel really bad, and I used to go and hug that person. So maybe that victimology was also there. And then I used to become an advocate in such a way. I did not know an advocate was there when I was such younger. So what I would go to my mother and I would advocate for someone. And I was telling, no, this is not wrong. This is what, because I will ask and I will actually talk about, or I'll fight that case out. And so it's something which in a very younger stage only, I think I was somehow doing something like this. And what happened was, like, when I was growing up, I was, Nancy Drew, and here studying all this, it really intrigued me that something I want is how things are going. I hope I'm clear to all of you.
Yes. Please continue.
Yes. And then, so when I was like, this growing state of mine, and then I was doing this psychology was only three. I clearly remember it was in Lady Shri Ram Mata Sundari College, and it was in IP College. They have kept, this percentage was very low percent. It was like 72, 73, and I was an 80 student. And but psychology when I started reading its synopsis. What is it that it said about human mind? And I was like, amazing, this is what I should be doing. So my parents always said, Anuja, don't do this, because do some English course. And this is not me somehow. I don't want to do an English course on something, or something like maths or something. That's it. I want to read this kind of human thing. This looks interesting. This is how I stepped into a college. And in 96, I cleared in flying colors, and I completed this psychology thing of mine. And at that time, I had just read it. It was just a knowledge for me. And just in May only, when I had to give my final year, that was the time when my parents, they got me married. So here it was my final exams. I got married on 20th May 1996. Yes, I'm married for 24 years. And I've got two great and handsome boys. My older one is 23 years old, and the younger one is 20 years old. So my older one is in Sydney right now. He's working with Deloitte because he cannot come here because of the lockdown. And the younger one, he's there with me. He came from America right now, and he's giving his second year from here only because he's in University California, Irvine. So again, great and very intelligent students. My younger one is in Dean list, so I'm so happy for my kids. And so when as I was getting married, I was not able to give my graduation papers. Yes, I did not complete my graduation when it should have been completed. So I got married, the honeymoon thing and everything was going on. No one studies at that time. I don't know, but yeah, so something happened at that time, and then I did not complete. So after on 20, like when I was 20, I got married, and when I was 21, my first child got, I just had him give birth. So my older one is 1997 born in August, and I was married in May. So hardly any time for me. And I gave birth to a boy, a child of mine, a beautiful boy. At that time, I used to feel, why I say that, because there's another story behind this. And I got married, and then this child, and then my second child was there in 99. So in 23, I was a mother of two boys. I myself was a child. I had to give values. I had to bring up my children. I was married in a Punjabi family, and there I have to become them also. I had to take care of as a daughter-in-law also. So I have to take care of me being as a daughter and as a daughter-in-law. So my maiden name is Trehan, Anuja Trehan, and here I became Anuja Kapoor. Imagine somewhere in between there is Anuja. That is Anuja which you're talking to right now, because I wanted to become Anuja. I did not want to become Trehan. I didn't want to become Kapoor. This is my journey which I wanted to start with. So because I did not complete my graduation at that time, it took me 13 years of my life to complete a graduation because I was a psychologist. That everybody will look at my children first, because if you are a yoga teacher, they look at your body. If you are a nutritionist, again, they look at your body. If you're a beautician, they look at your face. I'm a psychologist, they will look at my children. So I brought my children up with such love, care, and devotion, where I brought myself up. I was taking care of a family, I was taking care of in-laws, everything. Yes, there were many things, ups and downs were in my life too. And there are times when you do get sad. And I think they were, because of this, there was another complication which happened. So when my older one was born, someone told me, some doctor in first year of my marriage, that after that, like when he was born, that he has a leukemia. And actually he was a malnutrition child. I don't know how, but somehow he was not a leukemia, but that thing took up a toll on me. So he was malnutrition. Somehow he was just having milk because he liked milk. And so that was the time when I was also looking up at him, where I have to bring him up so that he is no malnutrition anymore. You know, when you become young mothers. And when my second child was born, again, there was something which came up. My second child did not came into my hand because he had meconium. And meconium is like when he was taking birth, that was the time he swallowed his own stool, and that become a mucus in his lungs. It usually passes on. So because both of them were my normal delivery, and so he had 100% blockage of one lung, 98% blockage of the other. Imagine, since I got married, there was something was going on. So first of all, my first child had this thing. And then second, my second child, when I was just 23, I got to know that he will not survive. And just in 4 days, when I came back home, I did not have my baby. I could not breastfeed him. I was in a bad state. My older child, who was just 1.5 years old, was always used to ask me. So it's a very phase, you know, you do your housework, you do your things. And I used to go to the hospital. That was the time when my child, you know, he was like four days, doctor said in Gangaram that he's not going to survive. But then you see destiny, it happens. And he was being given to a ventilator and he was there, and somehow I touched this Reiki thing comes up. That is why recently I've shifted from being religious to spiritual, and the spiritual thing is like I'm talking about energies. I'm no longer believing in idolship. I'm talking about spirituality and a lot of energy. So I did this Reiki thing on him. At that time I did not know, but just somehow I just did a Reiki thing, and this child of mine, and he started getting better. And that was the time he came to me in millennium. So we call him a millennium baby. 1999 he was born on 16th of December. He has Nirbhaya time, but that was the day of Nirbhaya. This date has always been remembered, 16th December. That is my son's birthday also. And he came to me after 15 days. So that was the time also that, you know, changed me also, how to understand the human perspective. How do you, when things like this in a very younger age jolts you, PTSD becomes a part of you, post-traumatic stress disorder, this becomes something. Maybe it was being there with me and I did not understand it. I was not counseled by anyone. I took that pain in me very, and things are, I did not want to trouble my mother or, you know, things around. So maybe that thing stayed me. What happened was, after 13 years, I got to know that I have a tumor. And now when I have a tumor, so the third jolt which came to me, that now I have a tumor, and my tumor is pituitary adenoma, that is called as the tumor of the brain, pituitary gland. So I think you understand, everybody understands it. Thing, and it is the master which controls the hormone. So again, I had this operation in Apollo on 3rd of October, and 2007, I was staying with my in-laws for 13 years, and then I moved out because my kids were growing and we need more house. So I moved out also, and that was the time when I got to know in May only that I moved out from my in-laws' house was on 14th May, and I got to know that I have a tumor on 1st of October. In 2007, 2nd of October, I packed my bag because doctor said it is bleeding inside her. And on 3rd of October, I was being operated by the best of the surgeons in India, and Apollo, you understand, SK Sogani and AP Singh, and these were the people, and somehow they were there to operate on me. And so when I finished from here, I flew in December for a 20 days radiation program because I took CyberKnife. At that time in 2007, CyberKnife was being there outside India. It was not in India. So I took CyberKnife. And so a lot of many people ask me, Anuja, what is it that you have this, you know, on your nose, you have this cut. Were you always a naughty child and all. I keep quiet. I didn't. So not many Grecians, and they used to tell, because operation was done from my transnasal, and it was a 5 hours operation. It was done from my nose only. So everything was being brought up, and I was at that time only. I can tell everyone is that I was one very, very strong-minded woman. I never cried on myself. So I never thought that I'm a victim. I always believed that I'm a survivor. So this first thing which stayed with me is that was the time when I got to know that I have this energy and I have this hidden beauty of mine, that I'm such a strong person and I can, I'm moving forward in life. Now, when I came back after that, my children were here only, but when I came back, that was the time I said, I will not die on my deathbed. I will not. And I will not die on, with lots so many of the now post operation problems, which usually happens, because mine was a benign tumor. It was not malignant, but its post thing is very bad because it's all hormonal. Believe me, my body, I have to take 16 medicines every day to get up. And people see Anuja like this, but it's a big, big thing. And so I have always been taken, myself very positively. That's the only way I could have survived. So what did I do was to survive? I started studying. So that is the time when I just started studying, and I completed my graduation. So I went to Dean, to the university, and I had this letter, and I gave it to them that, listen, this is what has happened with me. I don't want to die. And I have children. Please allow me to finish my graduation. In one go, I completed my graduation. That was the time in 2007, because of my problem, I started studying. And from there till now, there is no looking back. This is 2020. I've completed criminology with first degree. I've completed with victimology from Tokyo University, Japan. I have completed psychology advanced. I have completed law. Recently, I completed law in 2015, and I cleared my Bar Council of India in 2016. And since then, I have been a lawyer throughout. So this is my journey where I have what you see Anuja today. What I started learning and I started putting into myself. And from that time on, every day, I believe that it is a big thing for me, that I do not want anybody to die just because you are a victim of something. And that is why I started standing with acid attack survivors. I have filed their PIL in the court. I also stand with all the rape victims. I also stand with domestic violence victims. And there are times when people have cried in front of me, and I've listened to them with great compassion and love, because I know that what I have suffered, and I understand what being is. And this is how it was really important, that whenever I feel that I'm being loved, wanted, I feel I'm blessed, because this bomb is still ticking in me, and I feel that this maybe someday somewhere I have less time, so maybe I just want to finish what I am being born for, what I want to do, what I want to accomplish, and maybe one day the news is there, yes, she's no more. So I just don't want to do that, and I just want that when I leave from this world, I want all of you to be proud of me, what I have done in life, irrespective of many, many hardships I've faced, irrespective of that, and what I have gone through, this has made me more stronger. I have become more strong-minded, and I have, one thing everybody asked me, someone asked me, like, what is it, Anuja, that that you fear the most? I said, I fear myself. Why? Because I know how strong-headed I am. If I am going to set my eyes on something, I'm going to take it. I'm really going to work for it. Till now, I have not stopped from doing what I want in my life, and I will stand. I will keep doing what I am being doing for now, and to a larger extent. I wish I could have much more higher platform where I can work for each one of you in that power also. But whatever power I have now, whatever I can do it now, I am selflessly, unconditionally putting myself in line with you all and doing my best, giving you and providing you the best of knowledge. I have recently been appointed as a founder executive board member of South Korea. And I am so happy when I see my children. You will not believe. 13 years of my life, when I gave to my children in the starting, I am seeing their reaping inside. And I'm so grateful. Amit Kapoor is my husband, and I'm so grateful that he has always been standing by my side. He's my pillar. He has not only helped me financially, but he has also helped me emotionally, mentally, and psychologically. And I am so grateful to my family, to each one of them. And whenever I go anywhere, I think it is all the karmas and all this positivity which I have started believing in more has brought me here. So Rishikesh, this is my life. The rest is on you guys. If you want to ask me some questions, so that can be talked about.
So Anuja, one thing what I am going to do, as you are a very light-hearted person, and my father always say, there are only two species in this world. Jo bhi situation ho, hans khel ke jeete hain. One is the Punjabis and other is the Parsis. So lighter way mein main kuch bolunga. The aapka session ka naam, or the way I christened it, was my life. But now I'll say it is a goosebump session. on a very serious level, only person who is very tough from here. At the top floor is very tough, made up of steel. And at the same time, it's not only being tough. As you are a psychologist, you'll be knowing more than me what I'm going to say or relate to it. It's controlling of emotions is more important.
Yeah.
More or less, many people are tough. But it's about controlling the emotions in the right degree, in the right spirit. And I'm very sure, literally, it's hats off to you. It's an inspiring story and a motivating story, which many aspects I also didn't know about you. Now I've recently known. And literally, hats off. I don't have words to say. Goosebumps.
Thank you so much, Rishikesh, because this is what you hear. And this goes directly here to your heart. But I sit here not to hear this. I sit here because I want to do work more. And you know, right, this is what I say. It is something when I want to say bye to each one of you, right, in late night. I want you to remember me for what I've done, and for the women, for victims, for whatever I can accomplish, and I can give it up to you in a knowledge thing, because I love each one of you guys. And I'm so happy that I'm connected with each one of you.
Trust me, Anuja, whoever is participating in this video, who is in our circle, whoever is watching it, today onwards, you will be daily in our prayers. And may the God Almighty of whatever religion we all may be following give you not only a long life, but also power to do many things what you are doing for the society. The one thing about your aspect, if someone sees, is can be ki what you have achieved in spite of the challenges or the obstacles thrown upon you. But I see it from a very different angle. In spite of so many challenges in your condition, whatever is ki one way of looking at it, ki okay, there are challenges, there are uncertainty. Let me try to live it with my family. But you are going one step ahead. You are contributing to your family. You are fulfilling your responsibilities. But much bigger, you are coming forward and trying to contribute to the society and standing with those people who don't have power to fight for themselves or fight for the justice. It's hats off to you, Anuja. Literally, dil se bol raha hu. Hats off to you, Anuja.
Thank you.
Let's try to take the session forward. I'll request all the participants from all the social media stream and this Cisco web app, please punch in your questions. We'll be definitely taking to Anuja. Anuja, the first question I would like to take over here this is about the topic we might see very often, like the Sushant Kapoor case has unfortunately, Sushant Singh case has also unfortunately happened about the suicide. Then we also know the depression, what the celebrity, obviously with the media and all that we have seen of Deepika Padukone. All these are literally, if you see, from what you would like to just share on this topic, because if we humans, I will not try to categorize this as a country problem or it's a general human problem the way I see it. If anyone is going through some suffering, if some the boy or a girl is going through a divorce process, they will view from a very different angle. Or someone maybe the younger age also, someone would not be good at studies, or someone is not good at speaking in with a fluent. We try to create a myths around them and try to categorize them. And if people is not so strong, they will definitely try get affected by it. So how would you just discuss this issue of depression, suicide, and all that?
Thank you for the question throwing at me. First of all, I would also like to thank the people who have been writing to me, and they are writing such beautiful words. And I am saying from my bottom of my heart, thank you so much. You guys are an inspiration to me. I am doing for you people. Stay there with me. Thank you for such inspiration words which you're writing to me, and I'm just seeing it on my screen. Rishikesh, back to your words, your question. When we talk about depression and we talk about suicide, in my non-stop webinars which I'm just taking right now, it is basically on depression. What I'm talking about is depression is just not a word. Depression comes when you allow it to come in you, and how it happens, because somehow you have a personality, biologically you are being affecting with some kind of a disease in you which you have not treated. Is like somebody must have been suffering from a thyroid issue and they don't know, they're not taking up high their medicines on time, high blood pressure. They are doing something, lipid profile has not been done. So everything is not a depression. So what they need to do is, first of all, get yourself checked up. Are you okay with the problem which you're facing in a biological way? If some vitamins can be taken, please take it. Is a supplement can be taken? Please take it. Are you doing an exercise? Please do. Are you doing some kind of a breathing thing so that your blood pressure stays low? What kind of a personality you belong to? Are you a personality of a narcissist, emotionally unstable, paranoid, or a predator personality? Now, definitely the people who come into emotionally unstable are the ones who have PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. They come into borderline. They come into those areas of manic and depressive. So, but depression is a long event. Maybe for years it happens. It is not a one-night thing. So what is there is a stress level. It starts with stress. Stress on going to anxiety, on to panic attacks. Then it goes to depression. And then it leads to suicide. Okay. It does not happen in one night. Your body keeps giving you cues. Your body gives to all your family members, to all your friends, it keeps telling you, help me, because they don't come out and say, help me, because they don't know what's happening to them. They just feel depressed is because they do not take care of their stress on the very first level. Stress when you were as a child, stress when you became a teenager, stress when you got married, stress when you were working into a firm or into any workplace. Stress when you have babies, when you have things. Stress in a partnership, in a sexual manner. Stress where so many things are happening with you. You do not take it as a problem. You do not go and talk to a counselor. You do not go and talk to your friends. Talk with your partner. Talk to the people which should be talked about. Why? Because you feel ashamed. Because you feel that somebody will talk about you and they will talk negative about you. You will be chucked out from your workplace. You will be bullied in your peer group. You will be given mimicries, names in your relationships. You will be typecast, stereotyped, backed out, lashed out. And what happens is, in all of this, who is the sufferer? You are the sufferer. So I did not want to become that. I got an operation done. My children were into that phase. I came out. If I can, come to you. Who was my counselor? Who was my counselor? I became my own counselor. I became my own. I started treating myself. I did not want to go back. I did not want to die. I wanted to fight this. And when I started, because my personality is emotionally unstable. And I find I have a narcissist personality, because then only we can become a leader. Yes, a bit. But then you also have to have this emotionally unstable, because this is there with me. But then I am very strong-minded with over the years I started working on me. If you say that you don't change, I will not buy it. Why? Because even your body changes. If you have a stomach upset, you will eat khichdi only. If you don't have teeth in you will eat dalia. So don't say me that you don't change. I changed. What was my age when I got tumor? 30. I was just 32 when I got tumor. Now look at me. I am 44. I'm still fighting with these things, but I'm not losing hope. Because I started helping people more. And because I started helping people more, I am able to help myself more. So what is required is acknowledge the problem. If you are under a stress, please clear that stress. Please talk to that boss of yours. Please try to figure it out where and how the stress is coming. Acknowledge this stress, work on it, and then you move ahead. Because it will otherwise lead to a depression which is last longing. And depression is also on a spectrum. Somebody has a mild depression. Somebody has a mediocre. Somebody has a extreme depression. Everyone doesn't have a depression. So understand that not everyone has a depression. But depression is an area where you do not understand that there is a mood fluctuations which is going on. And the mood fluctuations is also happening like manic and depressive. One more thing I would also like to say, a lot of people have been talking right now about a lot of depression things are coming up. People are talking about depression and they're telling other people that you're depressive. It has to come from a classified and the person who is a psychiatrist or a qualified person who is into this stream. If you have been qualified or been diagnosed accordingly by a psychiatrist, psychologist, please then you see this term depression. Otherwise, don't. Anybody who's sitting at home cannot become a doctor. So this has to be really very big thing, which is what is happening. Like everybody's pinpointing like this. Don't do it because this leads sometimes some persons to commit suicide. Because they don't want to listen that they're depressed. Because every time you keep telling to a person they're depressed, they feel handicapped. Because they feel that they're handicapped, that they cannot take care of themselves. So it is really important, just don't poke people around until unless you're not sure of, or you have a degree of that, or you have been taking care of the patients, then only you go and tell that you have a depression. There could be a possibility that person is also suffering from thyroid or some other problems are there. So don't just, say someone something which is not true. And then when I'm talking about depression, as this thing happens, that this anxiety things is happening with you, you have must have seen there's a lot of people who also are obsessive compulsive disorders. So OCD is also there in this. So that comes in paranoid personality. In paranoid, you have this OCDs. Those people also become depressed because they're keeping on washing their hands. Now, if I talk about, as a criminologist, so I talk about criminology, pedophiles, they're also depressed. You know why? Because pedophiles have this thing, they see the child and they want to have a sexual gratification with them. They want to stop this, but how will and whom they should go and talk? Whom should they go and talk? They can't talk to this, their wife, or if it is a female pedophile, can she go and talk? No. If she can, because she himself, her himself are a grandparents or something, they will go away and run away. So we have to understand, if you have proper centers where you can talk about your problem without somebody putting and pinpointing you, depression is half gone when a person is there to listen to you. If you are standing by each other, you know, sometimes you don't even want big lectures from someone. Sometimes you just want, yaar main hoon, I'm there. Listen, like, call me here. Or let's have a drink. Or let's have a green tea. Or let's go to parlor, yaar. Let's do something. Or let's have a massage together. No, everybody talks about it. So what is this? Sometimes there are problems. There are many, as I'm a TED Talk speaker, and I've already delivered 14, 15 TED Talks. And in that, I have already spoken on breakups. So what do you happen? You must have understanding breakups. People get so depressed. They're not depressed. But basically, it's a stress level, which is on a very higher note. What they need to do is they have to talk. They have to talk and talk to their friends. And friends, please, you have to understand that if your person is undergoing a breakup, it is a big thing, because the breakup is means the breaking inside. So what you need is stay, listen to that person, even 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the night. I do get so many calls in the 2 or 3 o'clock in the night when the people call me and they try to ask me. You know, I get up from my husband's bedside and I go out and I talk to those people in the night. Because this is what has to be done. I have to listen to them. If I would not listen to them, what is going to happen? Because you never know. You know, if sometimes you're just talking to them and maybe that at that very minute, somebody is about to commit a suicide and that person stops. So what is important is a mass, I think, counseling needs to be done, which I usually do with my, whenever I sit, even if in media, if I'm sitting, I try to do a lot of counseling. During Nirbhaya times, I did a lot of counseling. Now COVID, I'm doing a lot of counseling. What is required is you need to listen to the right people at the right time. And the people who have suffered are the ones who can explain and tell you what they are going through and how they have come over. So these becomes the leading stories. I think that's all I can say for now.
I think such a complex issue, you have very well summed up. The way I have understood very briefly, and as a message, if I want to throw it up to the society at large, hum log sabko insaan banna zaruri hai. I think that is the nutshell when I say is that we have to hear to other people. We have to understand other. If you're working in an office, if you're seeing some colleague, his little discomfort or his maybe behavior pattern are not so normal. We should try to find that out in a more human angle by being a friend. And not being so judgmental character, in other words. At the same time,
we cannot go for a COVID issue, but I think just, you know, at what I feel, just hugging.
Right.
Seriously, I'm telling you, is more than right. Enough. Even if you had an argument, you know, even if right. You have an argument with your wife or with your husband or with children or anybody, when you know that you've done wrong, right. Just stand up and say that you've done wrong. And just hug, even if you don't want to say it, just hug that person. Okay.
Right.
And just think, let's stop this. I'll try to see something what can be done. Sometimes what happens is physical touch also really matters. So just touch that person.
Right.
Because energies travel. The minute you touch someone, energies travel. So maybe just touch that person and tell that, I'm sorry. This is what you feel, that you mean it. And it's sometimes like some people do not believe that sorry factor, because we do it again. So counsel yourself first. If you are doing something wrong with someone, sit down and talk with that person. What is it that leading to an argument in your life? What is it that you need? What is it that you really require? And if this much of an argument is happening, and for that you keep giving away your relationship, I don't think so. That makes sense. And then you talk about depression. So at that time only, why don't you just sit and talk with that person? If things have to go, then allow it in happiness. Let it go. If you think you can evolve, And if you can move forward, don't move on. Move forward. I moved forward. Moving on is I don't care. Moving forward is bringing up everyone together and then move ahead. Even if it is your ex, forgive. Don't forget. You don't want to forget? Don't forget. But forgive. Forgive in which way is when you don't want to move, you know, move on in life, because that will create depression. Moving forward is you understand your problem, you accept it, and then you say, yes, I could have done, I could not have done, I learned from this, and now I move forward in life. So there is someone who just asked me a question. Could you please let me know? There was a question. Kanika, some question came up.
Kanishka?
Yeah, Kanishka.
Oh, I can't see.
Be it in your professional card, what did she say? She's saying something. Kanishka is saying something. Okay, I don't know. How can I see the questions here? Can I see the questions? I don't want to touch anything actually.
No. I'll try to come back on that. Yeah. He's saying, I think the last post of his, he says, maybe I am more enlightened now. Very inspirational, I must say. Life makes you tough.
No. He just asked a question. There is something about it, the car or something he's talking about. I don't know what he's talking.
Kanish, can you just put it across the chat mode? So let that question come in the meanwhile, as we are running short of time also, and as you're, as in the beginning I said, ki, you have multiple personalities, and there was a specific reason I just didn't wanted to jump onto the question and answer session. But as I know you, and I wanted people to know about the motivating side. If I'm very sure, if कोई भी बंदा 5 मिनट भी सुन ले या 10 मिनट भी योर साइड ऑफ द स्टोरी, अगर उसमें दिल और दिमाग होगा तो डेफिनेटली मोटिवेट होके आएगा बाहर. सो नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेरी शॉर्ट एंड वेरी ब्रीफली नाउ, इट्स समथिंग लाइक अ 2020 वी विल बी ट्राइंग टू प्ले अनुजा, बिकॉज टाइम इज शॉर्ट, राइट? लॉ एंड साइकोलॉजी, वेरी ब्रीफली योर कमेंट्स ऑन दैट. As a law, lawyer, legal professionals.
As I talk about law and justice, and then we talk about law and psychology. So like law and justice are two different things. Justice is you put it with law. Law is justice is different. You can have law and justice.
Right.
Because in any way, either the offender or criminal will be, something happens with him, or a victim on side, something happens. So basically justice is what is you wanted to see, but justice cannot come from a law. Law is a different perspective. We will go by the procedure. There are times when you may not get justice. And then we talk about law and psychology. Psychology is understanding human mind. Psychology is understanding what you are going through. So when I sit in front of the victims, I understand on a psychological perspective, because when they're talking to me, they also know that they are talking to a psychologist. So that in one person, one man army, they are able to understand what psychologically also they are undergoing, and I can pull them down, I can listen to them, and I can read between the lines and I can understand. And when we're talking about law, this allows me to make a good drafting. And when I talk to the judge, I'm able to understand what they did not even speak. And I put that thing in front of the judge and I take out the order through the judge with my drafting. I'm able to bring and deliver when we talk about this. And then if that is justice, maybe.
Anuja, on a very lighter note, some naughty thought is coming to my mind. You are cheating, matlab, in the sense ki when you're going and arguing in the court with your psychological experience, one look at the judge, you know ki how to frame up your argument on a very lighter note. Koi sun lega. Chalo. Now next, let's see,
this is my tax, I cannot tell anyone.
So if anyone wants to
hire me to understand.
No, if anyone wants to gain out of it, either take Anu's...
Why? I am the one who want the people, let them come to me They can have both in one. No, nothing going. There is nothing. I'm not sharing anything. My secret.
Okay, well said. Next is on a positive side, I will try to raise this issue, criticism. How to face it? Because in offices, in the business culture, it is so competitive. We are not living in the 1980s, शायद जो अपना बचपन का दौर था, it was a very friendly times. We are in 2020. It's very criticism and also the social media.
Yeah, if you could see my TED talk, it's already there. Critics enhances personality. I would just recommend each one of you, if you could
Sure.
just go and you can listen to this TED talk, which is criticism enhances personality. You can very well understand with this.
Right.
Criticism enhances personality is basically related to how do you take that criticism and then you enhance. It means that someone is saying to you, they're criticizing you, don't take it on the wrong side. I'm sorry, but this is how it happens. Don't take it on the wrong side because the minute that someone is criticizing you have to understand that they're telling you the truth. Write it down. Write it down in your. Remember it. Work on it. Next time, they don't have things to criticize you again. So move forward. Don't move on. Move forward. Make it a statement. Take that criticism. Say thank you to that person. Say thank you so much. You have become another chapter in my book. Because now what I will become will be because of you. So take that criticism in your life, accept it, say thank you. It can be very bad, but write it down. Because that person, when he's angry, is telling you the truth. And that thing you need to work on. It means you have left that weakness of yours, which you really want to work on.
I think very well said. I have been a sports level sports person also. I have played cricket state level also. So two things comes to my mind. I always believe and I second what you just said. If anyone is criticizing, first and foremost, तो अपने को एक सेल्फ इंट्रोस्पेक्ट करना चाहिए कि वेदर दैट पर्सन व्हाट इज सेइंग वेदर इट्स फैक्ट और नॉट. इफ समवन इज सेइंग कि आई कांट स्पीक इंग्लिश, सो आई शुड बी अवेयर कि नो वेदर दैट क्रिटिसिज्म फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इज वर्थ वाइल टेकिंग और नॉट. Second is if it is worthwhile, improve upon it. If it not, just throw it in the dustbin and be a very tough nut. A small example, Navjot Singh Sidhu. When in 1984 he made his debut against West Indies, there was a big sports journalist who came out with a front page after his debut, Strokeless Wonder. And we all know okay, what Mr. Navjot Singh Sidhu did after that. One of the questions just coming when I'm talking to you. One more question I want to ask: how to respond to your colleagues or relatives' jealous behavior, talk when you reach to a better position in life compared to them?
Okay, this is what I just said. When someone is saying something jealous, what do you mean by jealous is? Have you ever been jealous with someone? Understand that. Why are you jealous? Somebody is jealous of you, let's keep that separate for a minute, but understand from your perspective, why are you jealous of someone? Why I'm jealous? Because I know that person is better. Why I'm jealous? Because I know that person has something which I don't have. Why I'm trying to find a negative, a positive person? So it means that you are better. So it means if somebody is jealous of you, better be. You move on. Here you have to move on. You can't help it. You can't help. Just tell them get well soon, because this is the way it should be. So if they're jealous of you, definitely you have something which they are not liking it. So work more on yourself. Make lot of more people jealous, I think.
Also on a lighter level, I tell it to everyone, though ki we should not be like squash ball. There is a game of squash, right? Whatever you hit comes back. If anyone is just throwing something else, why we have to react or respond to each and everything? Sometimes learn to be like Rahul Dravid and leave it to have a peace of mind. If someone passes some comment, why but just if someone is passing a comment, that doesn't demean mean any. I should be confident about who I am.
You know how many criticism I must have been getting through in every day, even if people love me.
Right.
And I put it down on every criticism on my paper. And you know how many people would have been jealous of me? How many women? And how many, you know?
This size of book.
But I would just say I'm not here to threaten anyone. It's just this, this is my journey. If you're jealous of me, be jealous of the fact that this journey belongs to me. Make your journey. Someday, I might give you a standing ovation. So rather than being jealous of someone, please make your journey worthwhile. Maybe someday, someone else will stand for you and will give you a standing ovation. So this is my advice, maybe, to all of them.
Next question, very briefly. Anxiety is something, and stress, it's not only amongst the seniors, right? It's also among the children. How would you try to discuss this issue?
The anxiety?
Yes. And how parents should take care of it?
So now, if we talk about anxiety, we are also talking about ADHD. You know, we also about here anxiety, disorders which are there with the children. I would always say that these are very special children. The gray matter is very small. It means they pick up things so quickly. Why you get irritated? Because they do the work before you do. And once they finish their work, they are, you will not also believe, they are not dyslexic. So be very careful of this. They are hyperactive. And they're very much children who are onto an anxiety frame. So it means you need to make a table for them so that they keep busy, so that they are in a format. Keep them busy. It is a big job for parents, and I know that. But parents itself, bringing children in the world is a big job. You should be prepared when you bring your children in the world. They will not become a package of you or what you want. You can select and put it in them. They will challenge you. My children have challenged me, and I have become a much better person. I have learned from them. I have said sorry to them. I have cried with them. I have laughed with them. And I have told them, you are a mini adult, and I respect their individuality. So once you start respecting their individuality, and you know that they belong, you must have definitely given birth to them, but you do not own them. So be very careful on that. Because you do not own them, you will respect them, you will understand them, and you will try to give them their best. And you will go further and take a lot of information about this from their doctors, from their teachers, from their students, peer groups. Listen, if you want your child to be street smart, you become a street smart person. So that is how it is. If you are not a street smart person, you will not want your child to be, because you do not understand what it is. So it is not wrong that you are not. We can learn this with our own children. Start learning. We all learn. Even if you're 60, 65, you're still alive. We're not dead. So it's not that everybody says, yeah, let's live today, because today is one day and we'll get die. I'm so sorry, we're living every day. Every day we are living and dying once. So when you die, make it worthwhile. You don't have to be Anuja Kapoor to die with a glorious thing. I'm sorry. I am a human being too, and I will take that stand with beautiful each one of you, and everyone can accomplish what they have been accomplishing in their life, and you all have accomplished so much. It's just this, you want the best of it. It's okay to have best. Just keep working. Do your karmas right. Have positivity. Things will fall. This will your children will also know. Create an example at home. Become a part of it, and your children will fall.
Very well said, Anuja. The next question, maybe the last couple of questions left, because we have 7:30 deadline.
Hi, I'm not able to hear your voice.
Can you hear me?
I can't hear you.
Hello. I can hear you.
Okay. I don't know what's happening.
Can you hear me? Am I audible?
I don't know, maybe. Just a bit, yeah, maybe. Can you ask the IT person to just raise my voice?
Sharad bhai, can you just do at your end, if possible?
Is something is there?
You will have to check it yourself, like at your end.
Okay, just increase the device volume, Anuja.
I've done that. It's on the full note.
It's on okay. The full? Okay.
Yeah.
As I was telling here on the last leg of our today's session, and it is a very worthwhile session, very interactive session, very emotional, emotive session, very fun also at the same time. And the way you have tried to keep such sensitive issues in such a lighter way, yet able to precisely, surgically, with precision put across the point. So one thing, there are chartered accountancy firms, there are company secretary firms, there are big law firms, there are corporates, there are CFOs, there are HR heads who are all watching this program today with us. Also, at the same time, you think it's worthwhile in today's time, all the corporate entities and all the firms should at least once a year try to involve some speaker or someone, I don't know how, it's just a random thought, who can come and try to motivate or ignite amongst the team. If you are this issue, emotional, the importance of emotions at the end of the day and how it can be done. Because if people who are working in a system are not only physically fit, but also mentally at their peak, then only they can give the best input. One example I like to give over here, as I have been a sports person and a default corporate legal person, I always feel there are a lot of learnings to be taken from any sports person. And now in the sports field, if you see whether it's the top tennis player or a top footballer or any top swimmer for that matter, they are in the cricket team also, they are taking the help of a psychologist to build over it, to enhance their mental fitness level. How would you try to put over here in the context of the corporate companies? They should try to do.
I think it is really important, because I've been sitting in one of these panels on, and I've been talking about mental health. Mental health does not require you are a corporate or not.
Right.
Mental health is everywhere. So mental health, addressing mental health, because someone dies and then you remember. So right. don't do this. Let's talk about, because stress, as I told you, on the very early stage, talk about it, address it, take a solution, make a every at corporate level, I would say, please make a room where you can just sit and de-stress yourself, have a cup of coffee or things around where there's a music, where there is greenery, make a room where there is a bird sounds, nature sounds, just complete yourself accordingly to it. And I think that is how it should be, where you can have a corporate level and you understand on that level, because corporate does not mean that you just have to be keep on working, because you need to look into your mental mind. Because we talk about promotions, we talk about productions, we talk about managements, we talk about the best of things coming forward only possible when you are all right. And it goes from hierarchy to the lower and lower to above. If you want more of your team to do well, I would always say that first of all, only a great leader is the one who will take care of all the people who have a mental issue. And every time, create a lot of these areas, talk about people, bring people around, keep talking even to the lower staff, the ones who are laborers. And please keep talking, because just giving them laws or giving them incentives will not help. What you required is give them an incentive of mind. So that is where you want, if a lot of productivity you want. Otherwise, I would say this productivity should be enhancing, and it is both the sides.
With that, we come to the end of today's web talk. Anuja, I deem it a great honor to propose this formal vote of thanks to you. I would, from the bottom of my heart, like to express with profound gratitude for you, first of all, agreeing to come and gracing this Udaan Saluters platform and speaking your experience and sharing your wisdom with all the participants. Thank you, Anuja, for interesting and a very knowledgeable and a thought-provoking address of yours. Such complex matters, what you have briefed, to us, it was as simple as drinking glass of water in terms of understanding the issues. I'm not telling that we will have the expertise as such, but at least I think that awareness would have come to the forefront. I want to state that we are most grateful, Anuja, once again, and we'll also like to thank two wonderful participants. Please keep following us in the Facebook page, Udaan Saluters, YouTube channel, Rishikesh Vyas. Anuja, thank you very much, and very motivating. And I'll be genuinely praying for you, for your betterment, for more power to you, so you can do lots of thing for the society as a whole.
Thank you to each one of you for bringing me on board and calling me and giving me that respect and honoring me and acknowledging me. This is very big thing. So acknowledging when I'm alive. So thank you so much that you have made me a part of your life, and to all the participants and all to my viewers and each one of you. Thank you, Uran. Thank you, Rishikesh. Thank you. Thank you to the technical team who have been there thick and thin throughout and making this great forum possible. Thank you to each one of you.
One thing is for sure, now on with your name, I'm going to annex just before your name, the word champion.
I would definitely ask my PR to put that thing.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you very much, Anuja.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you.